Hello and welcome, students. From now on, I shall be giving you a number of small homework or assignments to help you clarify your understanding of the concept in question, also to help you develop very sound fundamental programming skills, because this course is going to decide what you are going to achieve in terms of your professional career in a very big, big way. So what I am doing in these exercises is I'll be giving you maybe at the most 2 or 3 problems per session, and in a few days, maybe 3, 4 or 5 days, in the description of this problem itself, I shall post a link to the solution and you can take a look at the solution, but only after you have made a sincere effort to solve the problem. And most importantly, test whether your logic is right using the test table. So in the first set of exercises, I shall start with 3 problems on decision making statements using if else or else if else and so on. So I would like you to follow the instructions for your own good. So you are required to write the algorithms in the way I have taught you to solve the or to provide the logic for the programs which are going to be mentioned in a few minutes. Then next, it is absolutely important and compulsory to test the logic of the algorithm using a test table. Still in the comments, I see a lot of students asking questions which should never have come up if you were doing a test using a test table. Because that is the only way you're going to have a very good base on programming logic. It may look silly to use a test table or do a test table, but that little bit of laziness is going to cost you a lot in learning. So please do not avoid creating a test table and running through the logic. Another important point, simply don't jump and hurry to find the solution. Think about the solution a little bit. See whether that is the best solution you are able to give. Simply don't give a solution or something called as a brute force solution, which is simply a solution but not the most optimal in terms of minimum number of steps or using the minimum number of variables or making the logic absolutely clear to understand. And I believe you will have got a message from your department also. It would be a good idea to maintain an 100 pages king size blank notebook and do all the problems in that book. Mention the name of the problem, write down the problem definition, and then solve that problem in that particular book. Because later on, this is going to be a terrific reference for you to quickly brush up your logic. So even if you have done 40-50 problems, once you do it, it will not take you more than 10 minutes to revise it, because logic is a skill. It's like riding a bicycle. Once you learn it, you will never ever forget till you are alive. Now what we are going to do here is, in this first session, I am going to discuss about 3 problems I want you to attempt. Alright, so I will discuss problem by problem so you have an idea of what is my expectation. So these 3 problems require the use of simple decision making statement like if or if else or if else if and so on. The first one is quite simple. It asks you to write an algorithm to find the average of 3 numbers provided the sum of the 3 numbers is not 0. One way to understand a problem, which I believe is the best way, is try to think of certain sample data values. Say for example, if this was the data value 10, 20 and 30, this would have been 60, 60 divided by 3 would have been 20, would have been the average of 3 numbers. Now take another case. Here in this case, the average of 3 numbers is not going to be calculated by this particular question, because minus 20 plus 10 plus 10 is going to be 0. So here there is not going to be any average and you are required to print a message or just not calculate the average. Okay, so this should help you understand what is the expectation or what is the requirement of the first problem. So always determine what are the data, because now you clearly know you will require 3 variables to read the data. You will require 1 variable to hold the sum and you will require 1 more variable to have the average stored. Now let's go to the next problem. Next is again quite simple. All of you have electric meters in your house. Although the billing is a little more complicated, just I've given you a very simple example. So based on the kilowatt hours consumed, which is also commonly known as units of power consumed, write an algorithm to calculate the cost to the consumer, assuming the cost per unit is 5 rupees. So suppose your consumption is 55 units, the cost is going to be 55 into 5. If it is 100 units, it's going to be 100 into 5 or whatever it is. The last problem. In assignment or mini assignment 1, write an algorithm to find the largest of 4 unequal numbers. So far what we have done, we have found out the smallest of 3 numbers. Here I am asking you to find the largest of 4 unequal numbers. So this should not really be difficult. Again, you should draw something like this of a data chart or a data input. So these could be examples of A, B, C and D, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. So first try to understand that you will require 4 variables to store the 4 numbers. Then you will require 1 variable called as the large to find out which is the largest. So I hope this makes it clear that you are required to attempt these algorithms, and in a few days, maybe maximum in a week, I'll post the solution so you can take a look whether you have understood the concept. Repeating once again, till the point of you getting probably angry and annoyed with me, please draw the test table and run through the logic as I have shown you in the earlier videos.